to participate in such an important fact of my life. I have three parts of the program that I would like to discuss. First of all, I want to say about my family. You may have known, you may not know, I'm going to repeat it right here at this table. I come from a family of six. We were three brothers and three sisters. My oldest brother was married, he already had a wife, Gittel, and her son, Moshe. We lived a nice family with respectful parents. On September 8, 1939, the Nazis came into the city of Lodz, where we were born. Our family lived in Lodz for hundreds of years. Industrialists, they gave work to others, and they lived in peace with neighbors. A matter of fact, the city of Lodz consists of one-third Germans, one-third Jews, and one-third of the population was Polish. On September, 2 days after the Nazis came into the city, a truck was parading in the city with a Jew with talus and twill to humiliate us, and that's how it started. I will do the same at this table, take out my talus and twill and put it on and say the prayers as a Jew who they will never destroy. I have another document that I will talk about it later. When we start to put on twill and talus, I'm going to repeat what I saw when I was 12 years old at this table, where the final solution was talked about. How to eliminate the Jews. Please bear with me the time. It is very important for me to pursue this aspect. Baruch Ata Adonai Eloheinu Melech Olam Mishatev Baitalin. Baruch Ata Adonai Eloheinu Melech Haolam Mishatev Baitalin. Gott, weil du noch keine Männer verloren hast. This how I saw a Jew and the truck standing. Parading in the city of Lodz to humiliate us, to show in fear. Now I'm standing over here to tell those walls when we spoke about in the time of war, walls have ears. Now you may have ears. You will never destroy the Jews. Never, never, never. Because we have one saying in our Torah. When we save one person, it's like we save the world. Learn from us. The world talks about 6 million Jews, 1.5 million children. I'm talking about faces. I'm talking about names. Starting up with my father, Elimelech, and my mother's prince. My oldest brother, Yosef, and his wife, Gittler, and his son, Moshe. My oldest sister Rachel, my middle sister Malka, my youngest sister Esther, my youngest brother Moshe, who we closed the ghetto in 1944, took us to Auschwitz. My sister was sick. They took her right away, left. My mother and two sisters were gone to the right. I held my brother by my hand. They grabbed him. He was 4 years younger than me. Mengele, where are you? You did that. I remember your face, Mengele. I am sorry that I get emotional, but at this table, I'm standing over here. And look at you children, what you have achieved, every one of you. How proud we are, what every one of you gave to the world, whether you're doctors, lawyers, business people, creators. What did they want from us? We never asked for any charity or any burden on any government. But they saw us as enemies. My dear Rita, I want to thank this city one thing. For Leah, Zichrona Lebracha, in his memory, in your mother, Sabina, that they brought a child like you to the world. Fedor, in his blessed memory, Norbert. I'm thankful you have given me a life close now to 67 years. Who is no comparison. I will always be grateful for what you have done. We have brought up, you are proud we are of our children and family. And for this, I am indebted forever. Where is that that fell down on the floor? I'm putting on this table a document which for 2,000 years Europe did not allow us to become free people. We always had to be under somebody's direction in somebody's. They cannot take it today that we have a state of Israel, that me and your brother Fedor went to war, wanted to give their life. So we create a state so we Jewish people can hold our heads high. But the world today is busy with marketing products that they come from Israel. This they are busy. They're not busy with preventing Paris, New York. The terrible thing that we prepare over here. Europe, shame on you, what you did. Shame on you. Try to change. The Jews are not your enemy. The people of peace are not your enemy. Leave Israel alone. Show what they did for 65, 66 years. Brought science, medication to heal the world. They're the first ones to go when there is a necessity somewhere to help others. But you can't take it. Jews, you're not supposed to be equal. We are equal. We have a state now that we can be proud as Jews to live in equality. We have no enemies. Our cousin Arabs are not our enemies. It's the leaders who instate in them the hatred of us. We have all come from the name of Abraham. We all had one God. We may pray to different people. And especially Jesus, who never said he was not a Jew. In St. God in 64, we decided, I'm not anymore guilty for killing Jesus. Because that was the excuse. We hate you to spill the blood for Jesus. We didn't spill the blood for Jesus. In every nation there are people who are no good. And we should try to show them a better way. Now I'm standing over here by this table to show my family, who are doctors, lawyers, industrialists who give people work to make living. And this is the outcome. I'm one of six who survived. One of six in my, I don't talk about millions, I'm talking about names. Names who I see their faces day in and day out. Nights they come to my dreams, and no, I cannot sleep. But what do I see? I see my children who we are proud what we brought to this world. So let's be friends, people. Let's go after those who want to destroy us. And let's live in peace. Let's live in peace. May God bless you all. and live in peace. And let's not have Paris, New York, that blessed country who gave us the opportunity to live free people, the United States of America. Take a sample how a constitution is, and we live by it, that everybody has a chance, those who knows, those who wants to work. So thank you for listening, and also those who participate. I am sorry if it talked emotionally. I am one who survived from six. I was in Auschwitz. I was in Derna. I was in Wistegierstorf. And one time, one of those who even spoke worse than I German told me, "Woe is our Moses." Well, we were the first one, Moses was the first one who freed people from slavery. So let's take an example, and let's not enslave others, and think temporarily to live better. So Germany, a country of Schiller, Goethe, Bach, Brahms, Mendelssohn, yet the science. In 1915, a paper was submitted for change the world in the name you all know. Change the world of relativity, which we learned today yet. We did not comprehend what it meant. That was in 1950, and that was a Jew. I'm sorry, you always told me don't talk too much. I had to take it from my heart to understand, to say what I have to say. Thank you for listening.